Hello, assalamu alaikum everyone. Welcome to this lecture on pressure prism. This is a concept you can find in within the realm of fluid mechanics. However, before we move on to the original topic, we need to have some basics covered. So first of all, we need to know how the distributed force works and how the pressure works. Because the pressure prism concept is a very shortcut to get a very simplified solution for a bigger problem. For example, we have beam-like structure and it has a 3 meter length, and we have a force acting on it, which is a distributed force. And the maximum peak of this force is 10 newton per meter, and it reduces over the length. In order to get the point load we're looking for, the equivalent point load, because which will act on a certain position or certain point, which will not impact the overall case scenario. So in order to do that, we need to find the area of the triangle which is created by that force. So as you can see from the figure that the length of this triangle is 1 meter, because the distributed force is acting only on the 1 meter length. And then we have a peak of 10 newton per meter. That is the height of that force. We just find the area of that particular triangle, which is half times height times base. As you can see here, this meter and meter cuts out, and only newton is left here. The location of this particular point load would be on the 1/3 of the length of the force. Force was acting on 1 meter length, so it would be from the peak, it would be 1/3, right, around this position, which means we have to add this 1 meter plus this 1/3 to get the overall distance from the left side. I hope this particular problem is understandable for you guys, because from the next slide we'll be showing you something very important required in fluid mechanics. So we have to know that force and the pressure, they are not the same thing, because here we can see the force is acting on a length, right? Can act on a point, it doesn't matter. However, pressure does not act in the same way. Pressure in particular, we needs a surface area to work with, because we know from the equation that P equal F by A, where A is the surface area or the cross-section area. So now imagine we have a submerged body into the water. This is water, and because of the depth we have a change in pressure, and therefore we have a pressure profile. If you rotate this, you will understand that we have the similar problem with the previous problem we have shown. However, in this case, because fluid does not have a profile of force, however we have a pressure profile. What does pressure profile means? For example, if we have a height, if we take on the surface, the depth is zero. That means we do not have any pressure. So as you go down, pressure increases. Therefore, we have this pressure profile where we have the highest or the peak on the bottom and the zero on the surface. I mean the free surface. For the pressure problems, we need to invoke the cross-sectional area of the particular surface which is submerged. We need to invoke that cross-sectional area, also the area created by the pressure profile, right? Because the pressure profile looks like distributed force profile we had in the previous problem, so that we can solve that problem quite easily as similar to that. That is the reason we are going to invoke those parameters, and we are going to invoke those kind of solution into the fluid mechanics. So in order to get the equivalent force or the resultant force acting on the surface, we need to consider the overall volume created by this pressure profile. So we will be working with a 3D profile of the pressure, and that means it will no longer look like a triangle, but it will look like a prism. If we can measure the volume of this wedge or the triangle like prism, we will be able to find the equivalent force for this particular problem. That means we need to have area of this triangle times the width of this prism. So if the height of this prism is h and the width is b, and length here is defined by the pressure, which is gamma times h, right? This gamma is the specific weight of the water or any kind of fluid. So we can change this gamma times h into p, and h times b, which is also the cross section, right? If we just simplify the equation, we have Fr, which is the resultant force, is equal to the P, which is the pressure on the H depth, times the area of the cross-section area. So this is how we can calculate the equivalent force particular problem. Now, in order to find the center of pressure, we'll use the same method as we did in the previous problem, which is we need to find the one-third distance from the peak. Here, the peak is in the highest depth, P is equal to gamma H, and at this point, this is the peak, and we go one-third of the height. That means our height is H. It will work on the H by 3 distance from the bottom surface. And as you can see, it's a 3D problem, so we'll need to have a centroid for that cross-sectional area. So as we know, this is a rectangular surface and the centroid point should be in the middle. It will go B by 2, that means B by 2 distance from this particular point, then we can get the center of pressure. I hope it helps you, because in the exams, in the previous problems we have given you, in that particular cases I have given you the B equal 1. That's why you just need to calculate the area of this particular triangle. That has been enough. But if you find some problems which do not have or unit width, in that case you need to invoke the volume method instead of the area method. I hope this helps you to understand the pressure prism concept, and hopefully if you have any problem or question, you can write down in the comment section, and thank you very much.